Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Had a question about how to use freeze panes. Now, freeze panes typically is used to freeze headings at the top of the report, but the person wanted to know, how can we freeze panes at both the top and the left of the report? So, freeze panes on the window command, window freeze panes, basically what it's going to do is it's going to freeze everything above the current cell. So, if I would do window freeze panes right here and then scroll down, I'll always be able to see rows 1 through 5 as I scroll through the other rows. Now, in this particular case, I'm taking up a lot of space with that heading. So, what I'm going to do is window unfreeze panes and then use the arrow keys to scroll so that way I have just the headings, just row 5 visible at the top. And again, I'll go right here to cell A6, do window freeze panes, and everything above row 6 is frozen. But because I'd already scrolled rows 1 through 4 off the page, I can now see more of the report on each page. If I would need to go up to rows 1 through 4, I can actually go up here and see exactly in the formula bar what's in A1, A2, A3, A4. If I wanted to really get a look at it, I would use window unfreeze panes. Now, back to the person's question, they said, well, what if we have to scroll right, but we always want to see, for example, the customer or something like that? Well, you can use freeze panes in other columns other than column A. So, if I unfreeze panes, go here to cell basically G6. So that's the first cell that is allowed to scroll off the page either direction, down or across, and do window freeze panes. Now, of course, I can scroll down, but I can also scroll to the right and see the other months while still seeing all of those values out there in A through F. Now, the final gotcha here is once you've mastered this, it does not affect the printout. If you need those headings to print at the top of every page or the left of every page on the printout, that's completely different. That's under File, Page Setup. We have to go in and say rows to repeat at top, in this case maybe 1:5, and then columns to repeat at left. You can always just use the mouse and go back here, A through F. Click OK. And now when we print, if it spills to more than one page, either vertically or horizontally, those columns will print at the left and top of each page. Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.